After numerous technical glitches, today's gonna be a good day. Bow, 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 bow.
Fingers crossed. So we're finally talking about AI.
AI, that's the conversation of the day.
AI.
And you were a bit apprehensive about this conversation. Is it because it scares you and you don't understand it?
It doesn't scare me, but I think the big thing is that I don't understand it. I feel like it's moving at a speed so quickly, it's quite difficult to keep up with.
Yeah, the past
especially
as
creatives and people who have a kind of creative platform. Like, I guess there is an element of fear. Like, would people much rather see those two clans from our intro?
The thing that made me think of AI, and it is related, it will be related.
Stay with us.
It's not just a conversation about AI. There's elements of the show that can tie in. But I was thinking of a story from my nan when I was years back when she was alive.
She's dead now.
It's really sad. We used to watch TV on Sundays and stuff. And one time we were watching the adverts. It's probably halfway through Coronation Street or something. And it's sponsored by comparethemeerkat.com, car insurance. And she loves these adverts, really loves them. And she has a little giggle every time. Oh. And then one day she looks at me and she went, oh, isn't it fascinating what they get these meerkats to do?
Believed it.
She thought the cartoons were real meerkats, and I couldn't wrap my head around that. But that's
how we feel now, yeah. In some instances, mm-hmm. with the things that we see on social media yeah. that are AI generated.
Yeah, and you think, oh, that's not possible.
Is this real? What you're watching right now?
Is this AI? Is this episode made of all from all the characteristics and dialogue from our past episodes?
And it's AI has taken over the pod.
See, that's the fear. Like, you see the fake Joe Rogan podcasts out there. DTA, man. You can't trust anything.
It's wild what it can do. Yeah. You know, when you see things of, you know, like, characters and artists singing songs that they didn't originally sing. Yeah. So it's like, Eric Cartman, he's singing Sears, Chandelier. It's a wild.
It's mad. But can the creators of South Park just retire? Because they don't have to do the voices anymore. They could just give AI the script. AI just does an episode for them.
It's worrying, isn't it? Like, as creative, you do think, like, how obsolete are we? How long is it going to be until artificial intelligence teaches itself to produce things that are up to scratch of, you know, things that we go to the cinema on, things that we see on television? You know, obviously at the moment, it's not at, you know, such an advanced stage where it can, you know, write scripts and come up with visuals that we as humans are completely oblivious to. Because there's always that element of, oh, that visual's a bit weird, or we wouldn't say that. And
Yeah. It'll get there. With time. And Bruce Willis, speaking of film, Bruce Willis was ahead of the curve. Because obviously he's a sick man. He knows he's against borrowed time. He sold his likeness to an AI company for $10 million.
See, it's cash back, I understand. You know, he ain't going to be here.
For his kids, in it, I guess.
It's for his family, but that's something that I necessarily don't agree with, is putting people in films and stuff after they've gone. It's essentially taking a role from someone who's living and breathing, yeah. You know? I don't understand.
Yeah, you can see why Hollywood had a gripe about
100%. It's taking jobs.
Yeah,
it's took our job! Taking it's true. It doesn't sit well with me, you know, selling likenesses and stuff, because you're taking jobs, opportunities, you know, opportunities for growth away from People who are putting in the graft now, mm-hmm. people who talented are trying to people. Be the next Bruce Willis. Yeah. It's just weird to me.
Yeah, talented folk losing jobs, and yeah, it's wild to me.
So what scares you the most?
It is jobs, because like me talking about me being a crap paper male of like, I don't know, a tradie, like a trade, you know, having that paranoia, oh, you should have learned a trade, da 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 da. And I was thinking to myself, I had a stage of paranoia at work. I was like, you know, using AI for certain things. And it's like, yes, I'm good for holding a camera and I know what I'm doing with a camera. And you can't take that physical skill yet away until AI can create these images and shots when you type in the direction in a space. I think that we will get to that point where a cameraman won't be needed. For a live circumstance or event, yeah, maybe, because that's unique. And I feel like that's where live entertainment will thrive again, like theatres, wrestling, sports. That will always thrive. But I was scared. I was like, the last job, really, that will be, they will be able to replace like bricklayers and stuff. They already are in like China and stuff. They've got bricklaying machines. But for independent companies to fund that software and robots will be long dead by the time that's all happening. So I'm like, I should have learned a trade, because in 5-10 years time, we could be at the job. You know? And that kind of filled me with fear, man.
Well, I mean, something, you know, to a degree we should have learned from the past, because I mean, part of what you're talking about there is, you know, machines taking jobs away from labourers. Yeah. And that's been a fear for years and years, and it came to fruition, you know. Yeah. There's so many things in, you know, labour factories, everything like that, where machines have taken jobs. Mm-hmm. So it's wild to me that we kind of allowed that next evolution of that, mm-hmm. where then we are taking the creativity and the human mind is essentially what AI is taking away. Our ability to think independently, to think unique, creatively.
Look at the film Wall-E. That resonates so much when you watch the message. If you look at the message behind the film, that could be pretty spot on.
We're all just going to be fat people floating around a cruise ship in space while AI does everything
for us. Which is great, because all the food, it's sick. No, a joke. But yeah, it's scary, man. And then I was thinking of other things, like, you know, therapy. I have therapy, and I've done for a long time. And I was thinking to myself one day, like, I've got a sense of paranoia about the therapist being judgmental. And I know they're impartial, like they're not judgmental, but as humans, we are judgmental. We are. We can't help it half the time. It's just in our nature to be judged and think about someone's circumstance of how they feel. I was like, what do they go home and tell their... Do they tell their partners while they're cooking dinner that I'm crackers? You know what I mean?
I wish that blonde would shut the up.
Yeah, well, she'd get a grip. She'd stop crying. But I was thinking, could... With the information, obviously, that the internet has and that AI could have, what if things like therapists, because if they know the scientific answers behind neurological like stuff, what could they be therapists?
The thing is, this is one of the big positives of AI for me is, you know, and we say all the time that we acknowledge that not everyone has someone. But there is a gap. It, you know, it fulfills that need for some people. You know, those kind of AI chat functions. Mm-hmm. It's company without needing a physical human being. Yeah. And I know that, again, that is never going to replace it. No. You know, you're never going to meet them. You're never going to have to be physical. You know, even just be in the space with someone. That's never going to happen. But in someone's time of need, there is nothing stopping anyone from getting up an AI chat room and just just talking.
I feel like help me.
Because it's going to listen.
Yeah.
And, you know, it might throw back some generic kind of robot answers. But it's still going to be there to listen. It's an opportunity for you to get things off your chest, to get it out there. Yeah. You know, essentially, other than that human empathy, what else are you going to get from me? It's the lightening of the load.
Like, there's me thinking, is the person going to be judgy? Will AI be judgy? Or will it just know the facts without the judgment?
It's shedding the load without fear, you know? You know that it's not going to say anything judgmental back, or...
I'm not going to go and talk to its robot mates, is it?
Or is it?
See, what happens when we get physical robots then? Like, will people need mates anymore? Because they'll have an AI mate living with them in their house.
Right. The thing that worries me is that everything that we do as humans has to turn sexual at some point.
Why did I know it was going to go there?
Because at the moment, it's a huge thing around AI is, you know, the creation of deep fakes and the generating of images, you know, of celebrities, but also not just celebrities. It can be everyday people, you know, exes, current partners, people who are obsessed with certain people, you know, being able to generate these incredibly explicit and graphic sexual renderings of people. It's so dangerous. And this is what I don't understand, is why everything has to go sexual with anything that we are remotely invested in. And that's why, and the reason I say it is because if it did become physical, we know that people are just going to be f***ing these things.
Yeah, they are. And I wonder how many news stories there'll be about robot rips man's d*** off.
That robot ussy clamp shut.
Voice grip, you d*** off. Savage. You said something really interesting there, like...
Tend to.
People like, you know, get obsessed with people. There's things that exist like exes, revenge porn. Mm-hmm. Imagine, like, the impact on people's lives and mental health it could have if some psychopath had an issue with his ex, you know, put a video out there of this person. Because it's questionable. When that video... Cover your ears, Taylor. Like, when... that video went out about Taylor Swift.
Well, it was just a collection of images.
A collection of images, yeah. You know, even though it took a day or so for people to realise that it is AI, some certain damage was still done on that person.
Absolutely.
She can't have felt great seeing that was out there.
It's complete. It makes the person involved completely powerless.
Yeah.
Because... they have absolutely nothing to do with that. It's completely generated out of thin air.
Yeah. And perception is reality. Yeah. If you're perceived to have naked pictures and videos out there, even if some people... You can't tell everyone that it's not true. Someone will always believe it.
Take other people's perceptions away, because at the end of the day, they don't matter. It's the way that it impacts that person. Yeah. You know, it's so intrusive. It, you know, it's taken away so many of their rights. The rights to their bodies, you know, that was snatched away from them.
Yeah.
It's no different to revenge porn.
Yeah.
It's that stealing of someone's rights that, you know, it's almost that not secondhand, but that one step removed from, you know, a sexual abuse, sexual assault.
Yeah.
You know, it's completely taken away someone's rights on their own body. Sickening. Did look at it, though.
Did you?
For, like, research purposes.
Of course.
Got to know what I'm talking about.
Dave put it in the memo, like, it's fundamental.
This is on you, Dave.
Yeah.
You sick.
Dave got his job back. But literally, it's a scary thing. And just like anything, there's pros and cons to everything. But hopefully we, as humans, we use it for good. But we won't. We'll use it for evil.
And for our own interests, our own gratification.
Our own desires.
Because we're the worst. Would you f*** a robot?
Oh, I'm not married.
It's not real. It's not human.
No. That's the thing. Would it sabotage that in relationships? Because obviously, if you can program AI and a robot to do anything. Anything.
Anywhere.
Anywhere. Anytime. No time of the month.
Oh.
Whoops. Like, what if people who struggle with confidence and, you know, people who struggle, yeah, with social anxiety and stuff, what if this AI friend could be a confidant? And
I think it's nothing new. You know, it's nothing new for, you know, it's been a thing for ages where people will bring on, like, sex dolls and real-life-sized toys, you know, that type of thing to replace that companionship. It's seen as weird. Like, you know, no one understands it. You know, when Darren sat there having his dinner next to a life-size Chinese schoolgirl.
Yeah.
Like, we've seen it for years.
Yeah, you know?
But I guess it progresses it to that next step of being able to interact with them.
And they've got programmed emotion. What if, oh God, this is me spitballing, it gave me goosebumps. But what if someone was to lose a loved one and you could transfer their memories and feelings and DNA into the robot, and then you could have the conversations and you could just replicate your loved one who's passed. That's scary.
That'd be sad.
Really sad.
Feels like the further that we go through humanity, the more out of touch we become with each other and what our kind of, you know, purpose is to each other. We kind of cut every corner possible to interact with each other in a physical space. It's just wild to me.
It's mad. And I saw some that there was technology where essentially, like, wires are plugged into our brains. And we just sit there on a chair with a mask on. And you're in this universe, different universe, but it gave you the ability to feel.
Mm.
So you just sat there in a chair, but your brain can still walk around and you can feel things in this world that's non-existent. But so it'd be like this. It would feel like this. And then it switches off.
It's almost like the next phase of virtual reality, isn't it?
Black Mirror.
Which is wild.
We're going to f*** this world up.
We've already done it, bro.
Yeah, we're halfway there. Like the World War III chat. We're there. What was the need to create nuclear weapons?
Just who's got the biggest competition in it.
Did you?
Again?
That's all it is, yeah.
Obsessed with this world. Yeah.
Christ almighty. But yeah, like, hopefully it's only ever used for good, and hopefully it can act as a confidant and a form of counsel for people who need it. Because, yeah, some people don't go to therapy because of the judgmental side of it. And that's the biggest battle is getting there.
You looking at him? Yeah. It's why I'm sat here every week.
Talk me through that. Like, what puts you off? Is it the fact of someone being judgmental?
Well, it's not that. It's talking to someone that I don't know. You know, I don't know what. Again, yeah, maybe I don't know what they're going to be thinking. I'm talking to someone I don't know, and it's just, what's the point when I could be talking to someone that I do know, who knows me to my core, who can call out my shit. You know, whether you are being judgmental about what I'm saying or whatever, or you're just assessing it, you can call out my shit. I don't know why I would take someone's kind of guidance and opinion over that doesn't know me from someone who does know me. And maybe that's, you know, ignorant or whatever. But that's just the way that I kind of see it. I'm comfortable doing this. I don't think I'd be comfortable sat there talking to someone that I just don't know.
Yeah, it is awkward.
Who's I'm paying. That's another thing. I'm paying for them to listen to me.
Mm. I'm the NHS.
Well, if you can get it.
Yeah, it's a long waiting list.
There's just so much good that can come from it and should come from it. Yeah. It's just the way that we wield it as humans. Because at the end of the day, we're the ones who's going to shape it. Forget about all of this talk of, oh, it's going to teach itself to do X, Y, Z. If we pull the plug, we pull the plug. We're the ones who program it.
Yeah, yeah. Just don't give it, let it anywhere near computers with bombs. Avoid that one. It's always is a glitch. Can't call IT when that's happened.
Mm.
We've got an issue with AI. What they've done? They've sent a nuke towards China. Do you want to get on the phone and explain that to China that it was a mistake?
Nah, leave it.
Leave it. Said America. Oh, that's not my beliefs, by the way. That's a joke.
But yeah, you know, there's an element of it that I'm kind of excited to see how it does progress. Hopeful excitement in how it does progress. You know, what can we do positive with this thing? But my gut tells me that we're just going to f*** it up. We're going to take it to a place where we take everything as people.
To the bedroom.
Yeah. Hey everyone, we are just going to f*** AI.